Okay, so I'm recording now. Hi, Tracy, can you hear me? I think that thing happened that happened last time.
You see me? Yes,
Oh,
you
okay.
trying to get this on my iPad, but find you. But
Oh, hi, Tracy.
I may have to switch it out because otherwise I'm gonna have to hold this camera. So give me one second. This is my
Okay.
very first blab, you guys. I'm a blab newbie.
She's a blab
So
newbie.
one second in life because I'm gonna try and switch to the iPad that has a
Yeah, exactly. Tracy, I'm
dock.
gonna have to sit on some chair, something to make myself look taller, because you look taller. I'm gonna
Oh,
get the
you're
book.
so funny. Okay, I'm gonna try and call in again and see if this works.
Okay. I'll sit on a book while you do that.
Oh, no, it's just because I'm like really close to the camera because I have to hold it.
Oh, okay. Okay, when you're ready.
Okay, hold on. I'm gonna try and call you again from my iPad. So I'm gonna click off here and then I'll be right back.
Okay, so Trace coming back in a few seconds. So who do I have here on Blab? Is anybody here for this exciting? Let me just tweet this out. Anyone here for this exciting interview? Do you have any questions? Please leave them in the comment section, or should I say the message section. So basically, YouTube is becoming, well, it's not even becoming, it's been a very, very big thing. I'm sure many of you know that YouTube is something that has really been able to, really skyrocket a lot of people's careers, such as Justin Bieber. If you think about Esme Dentez, I don't know if any of you know who she is, but she has a very, very big career because of the fact of YouTube. So, I mean, even myself, I mean, I'm not necessarily, Mariah Carey or anyone like that, but the truth is, I've been able to grow a beauty pageant business using YouTube, getting the word out there, and I've had over 130 people in my pageant now that have competed. And I think it's really as a result of YouTube that has been one of the biggest platforms that I've used to grow my business. But at the same time, I've also used television, I've also used, other platforms of social media and things like that. But I really want encouragement if you're watching right now. If you want to actually go on to that ne go to the next level and use social media more powerfully and more effective, I want to say that social media, it is a very, very powerful thing. And if you can use YouTube, like try and take everything to that next level in terms of video. Obviously there are other levels to take it to, but using video could do so much for your business because it builds that like, trust, and know factor. People start to feel as if they know you, they like you, they trust you. Once you have them feeling that way about you, when you do have a product or service to sell, they're going to want to buy that product or that service. It's also a great way to actually build your confidence as well because, you have talents, you have gifts, you have skills, you have something to share. And when you actually go on something like YouTube, you actually are able to use your talents. So let's bring Tracy back on. Everybody, get ready for Tracy. Woohoo! Yay, Tracy's back.
Hi, I think so. Well, I was not able to use my iPad.
Yes, brilliant. Oh, thank you so much for being here, Tracy. Oh, I can't hear you. Uh-oh. The sound is gone.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you now. Perfect.
There's just a little echo. Are you?
Huh?
There's a little echo on my end. Are you getting an echo?
Oh, no, I can't hear it. No. It's good
Okay, well,
here. Yes. So, Tracy, congratulations for being this wonderful, successful YouTube, this blog, I mean, well, should I call you a vlogger, you're a beauty guru turned business coach, and you have over 20,000 subscribers along with over 107, literally 1.7 million views on your videos, which I think is just outstanding.
Thank you. There's an echo. If I could figure out my life, I can like hardly hear you now.
Yeah, Tracy's used to something a bit more glossy than this because, you know, her videos are all very outstanding, amazing, great, but this is like more hangout style, like kind of.
Yeah.
But don't worry, we're happy to have you here. So basically introduce yourself in your own perspective and tell us a bit about what you do, where you come from. You know, you're obviously from America and I'm calling you from the UK. So we may have like a lot of British fans here that would be keen to. I'm sitting on a chair, so you might hear some squeaky noises. But yeah, so tell us a bit about yourself.
Okay, well, I'm Tracy Timberlake. I am a beauty blogger and business coach. I am from the States. I live in Miami, Florida.
Brilliant.
So it's nice and like warm outside. It's still about it's hot. Like I don't know what that would be in Celsius, but it's about 85 degrees outside Fahrenheit. So it's nice and warm and toasty. Still beach weather, which I love. And yeah, and I'm so excited to be here. I'm excited to connect with Queen, and I think we've just developed a really cool friendship, right? Over the past few weeks.
Yes, we have. Definitely. Honestly, like it's really, really nice. We've met and we met through through Jessica's coaching program. And it's been really wonderful in that program, the wonderful community, and just, you know, meeting you has been amazing because you're so inspirational and so humble and
Oh
so
my God.
successful.
You
Yeah.
are.
No, you are. So it's really, really wonderful, you know, just to be here with you. And we're going to ask you lots and lots of questions. So are you ready for these questions?
I'm ready.
Woo! Okay, so the first question I want to ask you is, when did you have that feeling, the first feeling ever, or the first thought to set up a YouTube channel?
I'm sorry, what was the first thought?
Yeah, like as in, you know, like when you had that feeling of that, oh, I think I need to go on YouTube. I think I need to do it. Like, when did
Yeah, okay. So I had always been asked about, beauty routines, beauty regimens, things I use for my hair, my skin, etc. And so when I started my YouTube channel, I really just started it for friends and family. I said, like, let me put this up there and then maybe they'll stop asking me questions. And I can just send them all over to the YouTube channel to watch the video. And so that's really what inspired it was just other people and me saying, okay, well, let me just throw this up there. At the time, I was actually not looking to do it, full time or not looking to make money off of it. I was really just starting it because it was something that I was passionate about, something that I knew about, and something that people were asking me. And so I thought the biggest way to reach people was to start a YouTube channel, and then I'd be able to, put the links on Facebook, stuff for my family members, and that's really why I started.
That's really good. No, because sometimes people have this kind of epiphany of like, oh, I should do this. They have this feeling of a calling, and everyone's story is different. So, like you said, the demand was there. People wanted it, and you just was willing to serve and help people.
That's exactly it. It's
That's
just
really good.
a willingness to, to just help.
Yeah, especially like you said, when you keep getting the same questions over and over and over again, because it's true. People do ask the same questions, you know, how do you do this? How did you get your hair like that? How did you get your makeup like this? And then it's like you just probably felt like, do you know what? I'm gonna answer this question times, like if I make a video, then everyone can answer, you know, hear the answer.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, so the next question I want to ask you is, you know, how did you turn this, like this, when you started to make a video on YouTube, when you started to start making videos, how did you start going from just the kind of amateur to somebody that was just like, oh my goodness, I'm going pro with this?
I think it really started to take off at the end of 2012. And I don't know, there's just something inside of me that said, like, this is something. Like, at that point, I think I had
not even a lot of subscribers. I think in 2012 I only had like maybe 2,000, like right around 2,000 subscribers. And I just, it was really because people were asking me for more things. That's really what it was. And I started connecting with other beauty bloggers and companies who were interested in working with me. And I said, you know what, like this could actually be something. And the platform that YouTube has is kind of like no other, you know, like every day 4 billion people are watching YouTube videos.
Exactly.
And so no matter what platform you want to have, if you want to have a beauty platform or if you want to be a coach or if you just want to make funny videos to make people smile, or if I want to make videos about my dog, like YouTube is such a great way to reach so many people. And so, because ultimately I know that one of my callings in life is to really help. And like you were saying, like to really serve and be able to do that for people. I knew that YouTube was a great platform to do that. And so at the end of 2012, I said, you know what, I'm just going to commit and just see what happens. Mm-hmm. You know, like the worst thing that could happen is no one would watch. And that's okay. Like, you know, cause there, I'm still making videos and I'm still having a good time doing it. And it really marries two areas of my life that are really a part of who I am. So I'm really creative and I love creating things. And then I also love the business aspect and turning YouTube into a business. Like it was just a natural progression. Like I love doing this. Awesome. I can make money doing it. Awesome. So let's do it.
Oh, that's so good. Did you hear that, everyone? You can turn your passion into, you know, a money-making machine. But also, you know, doing something that you love and putting, like you said, your creativity into it. Because the truth is, you know, if you don't enjoy it, you know, if you didn't enjoy it, you wouldn't be doing it. So really, really wonderful to hear that you put that passion into what you do and that you were willing to give it a try. Because sometimes people only go for something when they know they're going to get these specific results, but it's good that you didn't know what was going to happen, but you were still willing to gamble and give it a try.
Right. And like I was telling someone, I said, you know, even if no one watched my videos, I would still be a beauty blogger. You know, like it's one of those things that it doesn't require anybody to watch my videos. I could just be doing it for fun, which is how I, you know, essentially started out, like doing it for fun, trying to help family and friends. And being able to turn my passion into a paycheck, I mean, that's just added bonus, really.
Yeah, exactly. That is fantastic, Tracy. Well done. So if you are watching right now and you have a passion, like Tracy said, you could, you know, you could walk your dogs on YouTube. You could make cakes. You could sing, dance. You could do, you know, you could do acting. I mean, literally, the sky is your limit when it comes to YouTube because... Well, maybe not the sky. What's another word for the sky in terms of the digital world?
I know. I don't know. The cyber sky?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly. The cyber sky is your limit. You know, it's true. I mean, you can take it, you can do it as small as you want or as big as you want. So if you haven't been on YouTube before, you haven't made a video, I mean, even if it's just one video, it can... You know, I've seen some beauty queens, for example, where they make one video and they use that as an introduction towards them when they're trying to win a crown or title, and it goes a long way. Or people that just create one random advert to promote their business. So you can use it in many, many different ways. It doesn't have to necessarily mean that you must consistently be on YouTube, but you can still make one or two videos that you could use to promote what you do forever, literally.
Right. Right. That's what's so great about videos and what I tell people, both people that I talk to as well as, you know, clients, as I say, you know, YouTube or any video in general is so evergreen. Like I still make hundreds of dollars a month on videos that I filmed 2 years ago. So that's what's awesome about it.
That is amazing. Yeah, that's true. Like you said, you're able to monetize it and make money from it. So that's really, really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the next question I want to ask you, Tracy, is have you ever read, like, what kinds of books have you read in terms of being consistent? Like, you know those types of books, like, by Stephen Pressfield, such as Do the Work or The War of Art? Like, do you read any books in particular that gives you this drive and this... I mean, because I really do believe that as much as we want to be passionate and determined, loyal, committed to success... not everybody is successful and not everybody is really willing to do the work, even when they know they need to do the work. That procrastination kicks in. So how do you defeat that, you know, that ugly monkey called procrastination? Or should I?
I definitely started out just reading. I mean, I think watching other people and being motivated by them works a lot too. But in terms of reading, I do read a lot. One of my favorite books, I think, that really started my journey into just trying to be a successful business person. Actually, there's two books that I can recommend. So the first book is by Danielle Laporte, and it's called The Firestarter Sessions. And it kind of walks me through creating desires or creating goals based on your desires. Job goals, life goals, and it really maps it out for you. She has another book that was like subsequent. It's called The Desire Map. I haven't done that one. Firestarter Sessions, I really recommend. And then the second one that I recommend is called The Law of Compensation. And that's by Marianne Williamson. And it pretty much talks about, yeah, like, if you focus on things that you love, then it's almost automatic that you will be paid for that. Because a lot of times, you know, our desires are very unique to us. Like, someone else may not care to talk about beauty on YouTube. They may care to talk about, you know, like you said, making cakes. And that's their passion. And, or whatever the case is. And anything that you do that is a unique and specific desire to who you are is on purpose. Mm-hmm. And just trusting in that and believing that that can sustain you. And what I find in talking to people and in coaching people is that they really don't think that. They think, you know, in order to make money, they have to work a 9-to-5 job. They have to, you know, work hard, work overtime, work 80 hours doing something that they really don't enjoy doing. And then when they get home, they really have no time for their own passions. And I just think that people die early that way. I think we should always focus on the things that we love to do the most, because that's really, I mean, it's what makes you. And a lot of times those things you're most passionate about are going to be really of high level service to other people. I don't know anyone who's passionate about something that is like only for themselves. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like everybody's passion is really to give, whether you're Steve Jobs and your passion is technology and innovation, like that has changed the world, you know, for the better. And I think that everyone has that capacity.
That's really true, Tracy. Yeah, I totally agree. And I think those books, they're very good recommendations. I remember Alex Speedin talking about using your brand words, and she referred to Danielle Laporte's book, and she talked about, you know, when you infuse your brand words into everything you do. So let's say your brand words are creative, talented, and helpful. So if you do that through everything, in everything you do, then you become so in line with your brand that people start to know you. They start to like, oh, she's always so helpful. She's really talented. And they start to see you as that person. And instead of you doing something just because, like an action that just, I must do this, it becomes more of a feeling, like you said. And allow people to experience that feeling.
Yeah, and so I have like those words, I have them up on my vision board. Because, you know, I want to make sure that everything that I'm doing falls in line. So my vision words, or my words on my vision board, for example, are creative and purposeful. And everything that I do, I want to make sure that I'm creative and that I'm purposeful, because that makes me come alive. And ultimately, I'm not trying to come alive out of just self-interest. I mean, yes, it makes me happy, but, you know, like I always say, if I'm not showing up, then someone's not getting the help that they need. You know, if I'm not showing up to live the life that I'm supposed to live, then someone is not going to get help. And that's selfish. It would be selfish of me to work a job that I hated for 80 hours a week. Like, that would be very selfish.
Yeah, it's true. Like, if you are just doing something for the sake of doing it, then it does become like, you know, you go there miserable, you come back miserable, and you're not really adding value, because people that go, like, for example, think about a teacher that teaches that doesn't love their job. You can tell the difference between a teacher that teaches and doesn't love their job, and then you can tell the difference between, you can see, you can see one that loves what they do, and the children know, the teenagers know. So, yeah, I totally agree with you, and Yeah, so thank you everyone for the claps. Keep clapping, more claps. And
clap, clap. This is so cool. I've never, again, this is my first blab. So thanks everybody for the fun clap.
Thank you, thank you. Sorry, we're locking this. I haven't locked the seat, but we're locking it just because our interview is very short, and I'm going to be on Tracy's channel in a bit after at 7:30.
Yeah.
So if you are all here, make sure you follow Tracy so that you can come and watch my interview on Tracy's channel in a few minutes. So next question I want to ask you is, I want to ask you, Tracy, about your doctorate degree, if you don't mind me asking.
Okay.
I think it's really, really amazing that you combine beauty with brains. And I want to ask you, you know, when did you decide to go and do your doctorate degree? What made you give...
You know what's so funny? Hold on, I got a message and I have no idea how to check it. I feel like such a...
I noticed the message coming from mine too.
I'm like, she asked a question. Okay. So I just decided to do it. I love education. Now I'm not an advocate for everybody to go to school because I don't think everybody needs to go to school. I am forever the learner. I love learning, especially, again, when it's something that I'm passionate about. And so I'm studying organizational leadership, which is essentially business.
Yeah.
And, you know, I knew that through getting that degree, I'd be able to be more helpful for people who are starting businesses, you know, and leading their businesses sort of into the next level. And it's been really great. And the cool thing is that I get to research and do research on things that I love. So my dissertation topic is actually on business coaching,
right?
Which is so exciting that I get to do that research, because there's not a lot of research. Actually, there's no research out there that shows any evidence of business coaching success and female entrepreneurs. So I get to, do this groundbreaking study on business coaching and female entrepreneurs and how, you know, it affects their success. And I'm so excited for that.
That is really wonderful, Tracy, because like you said, I think that there is the gap in the research, when there is a gap in the research, it's really important that wonderful academics like you are able to fill that gap. And, I go to this international conference every year in Bulgaria, and every year we've it's wonderful. And so every year we try and present something that just that, like you said, the gap in the market, just trying to find out what's missing, and somebody does research to fill that gap. And so I think it's really, really wonderful, and I think that can be really transformational for women in business, and also just so that when other people do the same research, they'll be able to refer to your work and know that they're not like completely starting from scratch to discover these findings that are really
right. And I really want people to know that, coaching is legit. If you get a really great coach, it's a legit thing. Like, and I think everyone needs one. Like, whatever it is you're doing in life, you need someone to help you. And that's
definitely
what I find. A lot of people who want to start businesses, they have this awesome passion, but no idea, how to get started, how to get things going. And there's no shame in getting help. Like, that's what I think I want everybody to realize, especially in my research, is if you have a passion about something and you don't know how to do it, there's no shame in, hiring help, getting help. And coaching is a great way to do that, because you get everything in just a quick, fast container that is so specific to what you're trying to do, as opposed to, going back to school for 4 years and taking classes that aren't really going to be pertinent, to what you're trying to accomplish, where you can get a coach for 6 months, 12 months, and really get all of the help that you need, one-on-one support. So I recommend it to everybody. And so the fact that I get to do this research is so exciting to me.
Yeah, it's really, really good, Tracy, because you are a coach, aren't you? So, and, what type of, tell us the kind of coaching you offer, and also what can people expect in terms of your upcoming launch? And, I know you've got a website coming out. What can they expect? And,
I'm so excited. I'm so very, very excited, because now I get to, like I said, help people start these businesses and really create online brand presence for their business. And people that I work with typically are you know, they're passionate about their industry, but they have no idea how to start a business, or they have no idea how to get themselves out there. And so I really focus on helping those female entrepreneurs to launch their businesses and gain online presence. Now, my specialty, of course, is going to be focusing on video, how to create professional videos for your business, as well as YouTube strategy, how to use YouTube to create profit for your business. And just the statistics about using online video is so mind-blowing, like how it can increase lead page conversions by up to 80%, how it can increase conversions in general by up to 150%, and people getting people to your website using video. Again and again, with YouTube, you have 4 billion people, right, watching YouTube videos every single day. The average person spends about 40 minutes a day watching YouTube videos. I think your video should be one of them.
Yeah.
Especially if you have a business.
Yeah, it's true. I think that's so true. You know, a lot. I think there are a lot of women out there, or even men, that just, they should be on YouTube. And, you know, sometimes I even see some friends or people I know, and I think, just even to do with social media, just that, not, I mean, obviously YouTube is part of social media, but what I mean is, just when I look at them on Facebook or Instagram, I think, if you just did a little bit more of this or that, you could really, you know, you could start attracting fans, clients, and so on and so forth. And I mean, we could all do with going to the next level, but some people haven't even gone on the first, they haven't even gone on this first step. So, yeah, so I think if you have any words to say to, you know, the young people or whoever is listening right now, because this interview is for a reason. It's not just to, like, for us to just look pretty and, you know, and cute, but it's actually to really inspire you to go out there, make your dreams a living reality. You know, Tracy has made it happen, and she's been able to attract clients, make money, and really impact lives. And I think that you can do it too. Young girls, ladies, mature women and men, whoever's watching right now.
Everyone.
Yeah.
Everyone.
Definitely. This.
And now is like such a great time. Now is the best time it's ever been in history. We have so many things available to us. If you aren't going to do it now, then I don't know when.
Exactly. That's so true. Do it now. Get onto YouTube now.
Now. YouTube. Make your first video.
Yes, definitely. So thank you so much, Tracy. I have to give you more claps there.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, this is so fun. Look, I get to clap and everything. That's so great.
Okay, so I'm going to wrap up the interview just because I'm coming onto your blab.
Oh, yes.
I'm so excited. So everyone here, please join me and Tracy on her blab, where she's going to ask me questions. So if you want to find out.
Yippee!
Yeah, so tell them what you're going to ask me just quickly before we wrap up.
So we're going to be talking about the art of success, because I think that success, there are a few elements of success that are required in order to actually be successful. And so we're going to talk to the lovely success coach, who's going to tell us exactly how we can do that.
Okay. Yes, that's correct, everyone. So look forward to seeing you on Tracy's Blab. And thank you so much.
Yippee. Okay. I'll see you in a few minutes.
All right, then. Thank you so much, Tracy, and see you in 1 second.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you, everybody. So join us on Tracy's Blab, and we'll see you.